In the brutal winter of 1203 to 1204, chroniclers documented something that defied all logic. While Crusader forces froze to death in their superior stone fortifications, local populations using traditional Scandinavian building techniques somehow thrived in conditions that killed seasoned warriors. But here's what shocked researchers the most. These primitive wooden houses weren't just surviving the cold, they were actually getting more effective the colder it became, while advanced stone castles were killing their own inhabitants. Everything you think you know about medieval building is wrong. The secret? Vikings had cracked thermal engineering that modern scientists are still trying to understand, and the most incredible discovery was still buried beneath centuries of dirt, waiting to reveal technology so sophisticated it would force us to completely rewrite the history of medieval engineering. The excavations at Borg Museum in Norway started as routine archaeology. Then the thermal imaging results came back and everything changed. Preserved timber from Viking longhouses showed insulation properties that exceeded modern materials, but that was just the beginning. Uppsala University's analysis revealed something that made researchers question their equipment. These buildings weren't just well insulated, they were designed as integrated thermal management systems, using principles that weren't officially discovered until the 20th century. Every beam, every joint, every material choice followed engineering concepts that modern passive house architects consider cutting edge. Reconstruction experiments at the Lofoten Viking Museum proved the theory. Interior temperatures 40 to 50 degrees warmer than outside air, using 75% less fuel than conventional medieval heating. The Vikings had achieved thermal efficiency that modern sustainable building designers struggled to match. But the timber was just the beginning. What researchers found next completely shattered everything material scientists thought they knew about wood. Archaeological analysis from Hedu Bay revealed Vikings weren't just using available timber, they were engineering it like modern materials scientists. Dendrochronology studies show they selected specific trees from harsh climates, where survival against brutal conditions created dense, resin-rich cellular structures. Then came the preparation process that sounds impossible. Cold seasoning, soaking stripped timber in near-freezing water for entire winters. Modern materials testing has validated this ancient technique. Cold water treatment improves thermal resistance by up to 30% compared to conventional drying methods. Here's the part that baffles engineers. This treated timber actually becomes more effective as temperatures drop. The cellular structure contracts to create tighter thermal barriers, meaning Viking buildings became more energy efficient the colder it got. Exactly opposite of modern materials. Reconstruction experiments at the Viking Ship Museum confirmed it. Walls that sealed themselves tighter as winter worsened. But timber preparation was child's play compared to what came next. Ground-penetrating radar just revealed something that made HVAC engineers question their entire profession. Ground-penetrating radar surveys of Viking sites revealed networks of channels beneath longhouse floors, sophisticated heat distribution systems that HVAC engineers recognize as more advanced than most modern designs. The central hearth was actually a precision-engineered thermal battery. Stone arrangements absorbed heat during burning, then radiated it for up to 12 hours after fires died. But the real genius was hidden. Warm air channeled through floor spaces and wall cavities, creating the first documented radiant heating system in Northern Europe. The University of Bergen's testing facility validated the results. These passive systems sustained human life at negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit with minimal fuel. They had achieved what modern green building calls thermal zoning, 1,000 years before the term existed. But even this engineering marvel was nothing compared to what came next. What archaeologists found in the roof will make your smart home look like a Stone Age cave. Archaeological analysis at Trelleborg uncovered something extraordinary. Automatic ventilation systems built into roof structures that opened and closed based on temperature and pressure. No human intervention required. These weren't crude holes, but precision climate control. Rising temperatures expanded air to open ventilation channels, preventing dangerous overheating. Deadly cold contracted air to seal passages, conserving precious heat. The buildings literally operated themselves. Experiments at Denmark's Living History Centre proved the system's effectiveness. Perfect carbon monoxide prevention while maintaining optimal humidity. Too much moisture would freeze in walls and destroy insulation. Too little created fire hazards and respiratory problems. The archaeological record shows Viking communities sealed inside during worse storms maintained safe conditions for weeks. The buildings had become autonomous survival machines, but the most shocking discovery was still coming. The feature that separated these structures from every other medieval shelter solved winter's deadliest threat. And it wasn't what you think. Excavations at Jarlshof revealed Vikings had engineered their houses to create multiple climate zones, the first integrated refrigeration system in medieval Europe. Areas near the hearth stayed warm for living. Middle zones maintained perfect food storage temperatures. Peripheral areas stayed cold enough to preserve meat without spoilage. Isotope analysis of preserved organic materials reveals sophisticated fermentation techniques that didn't just keep food edible through winter, they improved nutritional value over time. Vikings had created complete survival ecosystems within wooden walls. These systems sustained entire communities through months of winter isolation. But here's what will blow your mind. None of this revolutionary technology would have worked without the most crucial element that separated successful Viking settlements from failed ones. Archaeological evidence reveals operating these systems required knowledge more complex than modern engineering manuals. Every community member had life or death roles, maintaining thermal systems, managing food preservation, monitoring building performance. Children learned thermal management through formal apprenticeships as rigorous as weapon training. Runic inscriptions suggest this survival knowledge was preserved through multiple systems, oral traditions, practical training, even carved technical manuals. The precision was absolute. One mistake could kill entire communities within hours. This created knowledge preservation more accurate than modern technical documentation. Comparative studies across Viking regions show remarkably consistent techniques, proving successful methods were shared through sophisticated networks spanning thousands of miles. But there was one final revelation that changes everything. This discovery is why modern engineers are desperately trying to recreate 1,000-year-old technology. Today's most advanced facilities, Antarctic stations, military Arctic bases, sustainable buildings, use principles Vikings perfected 1,000 years ago. The passive house movement studies reconstructed longhouses to understand maximum efficiency with minimum energy input. Military survival training now incorporates techniques validated through Viking archaeology. Emergency shelters apply thermal principles first documented in medieval Scandinavian settlements. Here's the shocking truth modern engineering is rediscovering. Effective survival isn't about overpowering conditions with energy-intensive systems. It's about adaptation so perfect that environmental extremes become advantages. Vikings optimized for resilience and efficiency under resource constraints. We optimize for convenience with abundant energy. But when the grid fails, guess which approach keeps people alive? Climate researchers studying historical adaptation call Viking techniques successful human adaptation to extreme conditions using sustainable methods. In other words, they solve problems we're still struggling with. Archaeological research reveals engineering principles that remain crucial today. Redundant systems, passive efficiency, local materials, integrated functionality. Modern construction fails when external energy disappears. Viking techniques created resilient systems functioning independently of external resources. Emergency preparedness experts increasingly recognize this as essential for climate resilience. The lesson isn't about superior ancient technology, it's about different priorities. Vikings engineered for survival when everything else failed. As building researchers conclude, these medieval techniques offer validated solutions for contemporary challenges. How do you create shelter that works when modern infrastructure doesn't? The answer was buried in frozen ground for centuries, waiting for us to rediscover that sometimes the most advanced solutions aren't the newest. They're the most thoroughly tested by survival necessity. Think about this. Right now, you're probably sitting in a building that would become uninhabitable within hours if the power failed. Meanwhile, archaeological evidence proves our ancestors created thermal management systems that sustained communities through conditions that would challenge our most advanced technology, using nothing but wood, stone, and brilliant engineering. The Vikings didn't just survive winter, They mastered it so completely that their solutions are being studied by modern engineers trying to solve the same problems with vastly superior resources. They prove that true engineering genius isn't about having the best technology. It's about understanding the problem so deeply that your solution becomes unbreakable. Here's what I want to know. Have you ever been in a situation where simple, robust systems saved the day while complex technology failed? What traditional techniques do you think could solve modern problems? And honestly, would you rather trust your life to a smart home system or a building designed by people who knew that failure meant death? Drop your thoughts in the comments. I read every single one. If this made you see primitive technology in a completely new light, smash that like button and subscribe, because we're just getting started uncovering ancient innovations that put modern engineering to shame.